Hello, Scorpius. Tinkerbell Tarot here. Welcome to your love reading. Without any further ado, let's get started, right? Spirit, please, what's the current situation with Scorpio in love? What is the current situation with Scorpios in love, Spirit? Scorpio in love, current situation. One, two, three. So we got Queen of Wands, Scorpio. Are you dealing with a fire sign? Is that Leo, Sagittarius, or Aries? Five of Wands. Is there any competition going on in your life? Are you competing for someone's love, or they're competing for you, or there's just a little bit of gossiping and some animosity around you in your love life? Page of Pentacles. Are you entertaining the idea of inviting, or, you know, sending a message, checking out in someone, a message of commitment, or did you just receive one like that? Let's find out, right? On the bottom of the deck, we have the Emperor. Ooh, nice, nice and... Let me put in here so we don't forget that energy. That is the foundation of the reading. Alright, so let's start by the Queen of Wands. Alright, Scorpio, this queen is the most beautiful queen of the tarot. I mentioned some signs that you could be dealing with, but doesn't necessarily have to be at all, okay? Don't get too much stuck on that. Let's think more about the characteristics of their personality of this card and the energy, which is, yes, the fire energy, which comes with confidence, sensuality, passion, accomplishment, go getting it, conquering, like dominance, but in a good way, basically. Like, they're very, imagine a fire sign, they're really strong, they really impose their presence. This is also a kind of magic queen, okay? In a traditional tarot, she has a cat with her, symbolizing kind of a mystic, like a psychic powers. Like, you know, yeah. And so she sometimes can also be represented as a mistress, or, you know, someone very, very appealing, like beauty-wise as well, like, as I already said, sexy, but also like a mistress, okay? So, but this doesn't mean that there's anybody else on your relationship. I didn't see that here at all yet, if there's any, but it could be just you observing these energies. Everyone know that Scorpios are very sensual, right? Everyone know that's such a strong point for you guys. Everybody knows you guys are very, very sexy, very charming. You are just so, I love Scorpios about that. You're just so, like, oh my god, you can almost hypnotize someone, right, Scorpio, with your charm, or you have, like, seductive power, seriously, Scorpio. So that could be, you know, representing you on your, with a little more fiery energy. We all know you are water energy, but you know, you're really close to Sagittarius, the sign too, right after yours. So you can be absorbing some of that energy. And don't forget that we all have other signs on our chart. Oops. Sorry, my English is not my first language. So thanks for your patience. So then let's look at the Five of Wands, Scorpio, right here. You see red and black, black and red, and all in opposition. So it does mean oppositions. It does mean someone getting infuriated, you know, but it's not as bad as the Five of Swords, seriously. This one is more almost like it could, on the good side of this card, you can read this card as a competition, like even a friendly competition could be too, you know, like when you're playing video games and you want to win at all costs, whatever. It's something like that too, okay? This is on the good side of this card, could be competition that is just gonna be you're gaining more skills. You always gain something from that. But on the lower end, as I said, it could be competition for your love. It could be that you're competing. You wanna, you know, maybe there is someone else, like, on their lives, and you're trying to steal them to you. So, yeah, it could be that as well. And then we have the Page of Pentacles. So, right here, we wanna talk about this, is that could be dealing with an earth sign, like, you know, Taurus, Virgo, and Capricorn. But it's more like a message or children, right? Pages are kids, so it could be also considered sometimes an immature energy. Could also be indicating premature conversations, innocent or naive, or like, you know, but since it's kind of messengers too, they are all about message and communicating, and is the Pentacles, which is a practical thing, so you could have a message here of commitment or investment on this relationship. So one could go to the other and say, hey, I was invited for dinner, or I want to invite you for interesting. Could be that too. Someone may be playing with you and telling you that they have been receiving invitations, you know, out, or it could be with the Five of Wands screen stirring the pot, you know, trying to get some attention from you by telling you that they have other suitors, right? Something like that. But it's always the message. You could be entertaining the idea or sending some kind of message of, you know, simple, as low as going out for dinner, or it can be as big as, hey, I want to move in together with you. Hey, let's get married. Could be, you know, it's message of commitment. Let's see about the Emperor, okay? Emperor, the reunion of all the kings of the tarot. This is a dominant card, definitely a very masculine energy, action, getting things on their way, conquering, victory, controlling, you know, just imagine everything a king would be. Okay, that's this card. So we have that underneath the entire reading. So it has to do with power too. So I wonder if the beginning of this reading here, we're talking about a power struggle with this competition card here, this invitation, this communication. And the Queen of Wands there, ready to hold that knife for some reason, right, on this deck. Yeah, it could have some power trip going on your reading, Scorpio. Let's see what that takes us to, right? Let's get going. Why don't we get, I love especially to go ahead and get some clarifications. All right. Hey, Spirit, could you please clarify King of Wands for Scorpio? Clarify King of Wands for Scorpio. Okay, yes. Here we can see perhaps a little more of, this is the Lovers, okay? Which is soulmates, eye to eye, soul to soul, look how they connect, okay, partnership, the Lovers. Some readers do see this as another party, okay? Some people also see this card as a breakup sometimes even, okay? But we pulled this card to clarify the Queen of Wands, and it's not for everybody. So there are two scenarios that I can see this playing out on this reading. The first one is that you or your partner are embracing this amazing sexual energy of big connection, hot, you have a hot connection, a lot of passion going on there, okay? Your story is so beautiful, like this relationship is so hot right now, like it's so much passion in there. You feel like so connected, like two are one. So that's scenario number one. And then there is the scenario number two. I don't see a lot of that here, so it's for very few of you that yes, could have us at another party, and the Queen of Wands could be the third party, the other woman or man with that kind of energy, okay? Let's see what the Five of Wands, what is the Five of Wands for Scorpio? What is the Five of Wands? This one. Oh, wow. Yeah, this competition here is not being fun for you or your partner. Someone is feeling this way. They stay awake at night. They're suffering a lot with this game. They are not happy about it. They're very, very anxious. They're getting even paranoid. It's affecting them a lot, and not healthy, right? So yeah, it's a serious competition going on. People are probably even like slandering, throwing out a smear campaign against your decision. They could be gossiping behind your back, creating rumors. Not a fun place to be. Is that happening, Scorpio? Would you tell me? Would you share with me? So me and my guides, we could definitely like be more precise when we do your readings here. Okay, now cards are starting to show. My guides here are telling me with this card, the tarot is telling me that yes, the competition here is a struggle of balance. There's an imbalance, giving and receiving, okay? That's the scenario number one. All this anxiety, competition is an imbalance about giving and receiving here, and that's getting the person very afflicted and anxious. They are almost suspecting, so now they're almost suspecting that there is someone else, okay? Or maybe they heard some immature communication that there's a third party, and that either you or they heard that the other partner is giving to two, you see, two people, meaning entertaining, giving attention to someone else. Doesn't mean you're really cheating, but you know, they can be taking this as if you are interested in someone else, or you took this communication from this card here that they are communicating, or you know, flirting around, or who knows. It can be as simple and nothing, just like a little flirt, or it could be as far as, yeah, sleeping together. That it's a huge spectrum there. You know, we're having a general reading here, so I cannot get that as specific, but there is a suspect, someone is suspecting that the other one is doing that, and the suspicious came from this page of Pentacles that also can represent social media BS, right? Like, okay, let's say your partner decided to look at your Facebook, whatever page, one of your social media pages, then they see that your sister is friends with became friends with an ex of yours, or they see, so now they think that you guys are seeing each other behind their backs, you see? So it's something like that, really, because it's immature, it's premature, it's not fact, okay? Or they think that you saw each other because maybe they see a friend of yours on Facebook talking about a event that they didn't know you went to, that they think you hide from them. So it could be that, and that's making, it's causing all this to them. They're thinking that they have competition, they think that you're cheating, they think that the other person's super hot, and blah, 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 blah. So that's one of the scenarios here. Or it could be the opposite, right? Could be that you, Scorpio, are doing all that. You went online, you looked at your friends, your love interest Facebook, and then you see one of their friends mentioning something that happened like last night, and you were not invited, and you know that an attractive woman is there, and you were suspecting that they, you know, were looking, you know, they were interested in that person. Now you think they're cheating, you're nervous, and this could be that kind of communication, okay? So it's not, doesn't necessarily need to come as a message, but can be like a fabricated or created, not fabricated, because that's like lies, right? I don't know, but it could be like imagination, because the tarot here is giving me those hints that there is a, could be a third person, whatever, but it's not a fact. Okay, so it's giving me a hint that's more like suspicions, that's more on someone's head, that may not even be happening. But not necessary, it could be that the doubts are truth too, okay? It doesn't tell me that much if it's founded or not, okay? So let's see more about this. What is about this page of... Ooh, oh yeah, look at that, Queen of Swords. Ooh, wow. The Queen of Swords, guys. Queen of Swords. This woman is ruthless, okay? She's a cool chick, man. She's pretty fair. But she's all intellect. She's logic. She's all about no bullshit. There's no BS with her. If you're gonna blah, blah, blah her, she's gonna cut you off because she knows the truth. She lets you speak. Yeah, you can talk to her, clarify things. She will evaluate things. She's very fair. It's almost like she's a judge or the legal system, right? Like, she really tries to be very, very fair. But she doesn't take BS, and she can be really harsh with punishments if it's someone is wrong and with bad intentions, okay? She has no wishy-washy about cutting it off of her life. And since this was the Page of Pentacles clarified by the Queen of Swords, it tells me that it's about truth, or a truth that could have came out, or untruth, right? Because it's an immature energy, so they're saying or showing something that seems like a truthful. Can you clarify again the Page of Pentacles, please? Okay. Oh yeah, Tower. Oh my God. Yes, the Tower moment. So this was shocking. Whatever the message was here was so shocking to you or to the person that you're interested, Scorpio, so shocking that they want to cut it off, this relationship they're thinking in. It's killing them, or it's killing you. either one of you. It's so painful. It's destroying everything you thought. It was so shocking. It's like it took the floor out of your feet, or they pulled the mat under you, or you pulled the mat under them. Whatever that message was, maybe they saw you inviting someone out, or you saw them inviting someone out. Wow. Very, very painful. Very, very painful. I'm sorry, Scorpios. I love you guys so much. I don't want to see you guys going through pain or your loved one. I don't like that energy at all over there. All right. Five of Cups. Okay. All right. This is regret, guys. This is grief. Okay. This is being stuck on what is lost. There's a lot of sorrow here. People are not looking at the good side of things either. Yeah, it seems like there's some drama going on. But I'm not downplaying the drama. It's serious. It's serious stuff. There's the Tower here. Oh yeah, look at King of Pentacles now. Which means the ultimate stability and commitment. This means that whatever was stable, it's not anymore. As I said, the mat was taken out of underneath you or them. Things are all over the place now. It's very disturbing because something that was granted is no longer even an option apparently there. It's a very scary situation. Like, you know, you think everything is going one way and out of the sun and with the Tower moment and some truth and someone really screws up. Either you or your partner really screwed up something. Let's see. Oh my God, look, the Tower again, guys. Holy moly, double Tower. Oh, sorry, you guys. I'm sorry. I really am. It's not fun to be on that place at all. I get it. I would suggest you to... Well, I shouldn't suggest anything because this is a tarot reading and the spirit should suggest to you, but it is saying that exactly what I said. There's a lot of regret. Someone is almost, it's probably even depressed in here, looking at what was lost. By the way, I'm sorry, someone is knocking here. You know, I decided to leave your reading too very early because I love the daylight and I love you guys, Scorpios, to make it really pretty, but they decided to do some I guess construction around here and I have to have these videos out, so I had to do it anyways. I apologize if you're hearing some knocking. But let's go back here. So guys, with the Tower here, it's totally telling me that this grief, this like going over and over again, this sadness, this loss is about your relationship, what you guys wanted together, what it was going through that totally shaked out. Look, it's double Tower. It's about this kid or this kind of message that was received about the relationship. Maybe someone came out and said the truth, even. Maybe it's nothing about Facebook or third party talks, it's just someone came and broke up. Could be as simple as that. And yeah, I don't see a lot of third parties here. I see a worry that there is, but I don't see as a fact. It's not coming. It's just coming that some kind of communication made one of you or both, the relationship, both really shake. Like, it's over, basically. Here we can see with the Queen of Swords. I think it's a breakup. It's a screaming breakup in here. Huh. I would like to know now a little bit more, like, how about trying to figure out what is that, how is that you are seeing them, how is that Scorpio seeing their partner right now. Let me pull this way, okay, a little more. I think you still can see it, right? How is the Scorpio seeing their partner right now, or their love interest? Spirit, how are they seeing their love interest right now? One, two, three. Oh, wow, Nine of Swords again. Again, look. Again. The Chariot. Yeah. And King of Cups. Okay, two kings here. A lot of kings in here. You're seeing them this way. Maybe you were the one that caused the... Hi Scorpio, I'm back. Sorry if there was some cut here, some technical issues, but I'm right back. Yeah, I'm telling you, your reading is being very, very interesting. So, as I said, someone here is seeing each other. I mean, there's a lot of anxiety. There is a lot of love. But someone could be playing with someone else's feelings right now too. There is you're seeing them with a lot of love, but you're moving on, or it's all the opposite, right? They see you with a lot of love, but they're moving on. It could be also that there's traveling, or that you guys are long distance. But it's pretty turbulent, I'm going to be honest with you. Let's see now, how is that your partner sees you? Or partner, I shouldn't say that, right? We don't know, but just your love interest. How is the Scorpio's love interest seeing Scorpio? Three cards. The Star. Oh, they have a lot of hope. They are very wishful. They're hoping. You could be dealing with an Aquarius as well. There's Aquarius energy in there. Let's see. The Hermit. There's Virgo energy too. And the Three of Swords. Oh my God, I'm afraid, Scorpio, that you were the one that broke up. Again, the energy is interchangeable and could definitely be them. Because, you know, I actually should stop asking how they see you or you see them. Because this can always twist. And my experience is that can always twist and be the other way. But apparently, by my question... is that they see you, they're seeing you, either they are seeing you very wishful, or they are very wishful towards you, right? They're very in faith, they really want to get back together, they want the situation to get better, but they're seeing you like, you guys are not communicating right now. Or you don't want to communicate, there's a no contact thing going on, silent treatment, or they're seeing you very quiet, or they are becoming very quiet. See, like you're hiding something, you're hiding gold here, you're not showing all your cards, or they are not showing all their cards. And there's the Three of Swords. They're seeing you heartbroken, or they're seeing you breaking their heart, right? And that's where that suspicion of a third party is coming from. Looks like now with the Three of Swords, I can see that could the chances of having a third party is a little bit bigger, okay? Yeah, Scorpio, this is what I have for you. It seems like you were in the midst of a breakup. There is a lot of pain here. There was a lot of shocking news. And let's see what is the advice. I almost forgot. Let's see what is the advice for Scorpio, so Scorpio can get what they want from these. Please, what is the advice? What should Scorpio do so they can fulfill their, you know, journey? Seven of Wands, okay? You see, it's the advice is, yeah, you need to defend yourself. Or if you're the cross watcher that Scorpio did that to you, this advice is for you too, okay? Oh, wow. Yeah, seems like this is a serious stuff. It's lame, guys. It's serious stuff. People are up to no good. There was a huge deceit here. And it was not fair. It's when the Five of Swords comes in. Remember, in the beginning was the Five of Wands. But now, with the Five of Swords, things gets a little bit to the next level where... it's petty, it's very petty, meaning someone is really abusive, is being abusive, really, like they're so, the dispute is so ridiculous to the point that it's like the fight is so unfair. It's like they bound someone to a tree and then they start beating them, how, and then they feel victorious because they win, because the other person cannot move and defend themselves. So it's unfair victories like that, for example, or it's very petty, it's a lot of immaturity. Eight of Cups, someone is leaving, this is very painful, or they're detaching emotionally for sure. Okay, alright, here's the advice. The advice for either you or the cross watcher that is watching this is to be proactive right now. Because you're being beat up, man. I mean, or there's a huge main thing going on, very negative, and you need to detach yourself emotionally and move on. This card sometimes can totally be a coming back, okay? So it's not a definitive gone, but at the moment, you definitely need to go for your wishes, for a more wishful situation. Yeah, that's more stable, to also grant yourself some honor, okay, to get the remaining of your pride, because this is being ugly. So the advice is for you to save your honor, like save yourself, self-love, right? How can I say, stand up to yourself, to preserve your self-worth and walk away, because this is becoming nasty. It doesn't deserve, like, you don't need to lower yourself to this level of situation right now. To be proactive that way, to defend yourself, and the best way to stand up and defend yourself at this point, because this is ugly, the Five of Swords, is by walking away emotionally. Even if you don't leave physically, you have to do it emotionally. Distance yourself from these, because this is very toxic for you, very, very toxic. So that's the advice, so you can preserve your self-worth, your value as a human being, as a person, your value on this relationship. That would be also even the only way to save the relationship in the future, that if you want, right? Because once you walk away and you start giving yourself more self-love, you may not even want to go back to a relationship where someone put you in that position to start with, right? But again, this is a general reading, and there's a lot of levels of where they're putting you, but there's always boundaries, right, guys? You gotta set a limit and say, nobody should ever treat me this way or do this with me, and this is a deal breaker. Or if it's just close to the deal breaker, let's say if it's just close and you walk away, then maybe there's a way to amend this in the future, right? Because people can change, they can learn. But if they hit that point, man, I mean, this is about you preserving your value as a human being. You're a child of this world. You deserve to be respected. So again, walking away emotionally, saving your heart, because this is heartbreaking. This is very ugly. There's a lot of, it's a group of people even. It's almost bullying. Could be people with their family around too. For some reason, I feel that this not showing on the cards. Other readers may go, where is she seeing family here? Yeah, there isn't, but I'm feeling it. I'm intuitive. So it looks like the message for you, some of you, has the family involved, or a group of friends. There's a group that I see, and that other readers would see that too. There's a group against this relationship somehow. Could be from work, a group of people at work. Huh, thanks spirit, they just told me that. But again, it's not for everybody, it's for some of you, Scorpio. And the seven ones, look at that hand, like this. Yeah, standing up for yourself, preserving yourself, okay, sweeties? I wish you the best. I love you so much, Scorpio. You're so special, okay? Preserve yourself. I mean, self-love, okay? Self-love doesn't mean being a narcissist, you know, like, just think about yourself. That's not it, but it's preserving your basic needs and respect, right? You can only love someone else if you love yourself, okay? Enough, it's enough. Nobody can treat you in a certain way that you wouldn't treat someone, right? So this is what I have for you. Would you please support me? I'm new on YouTube. I really need your support. Please hit the subscribe button. It will help me so much. What comes around goes around. That's something free for you to do, and you're just hitting there so I can give you even more of these, you know, this content. Hit the like button also on this video. It helps me so much. I love you so much. Thanks for your love. Make some comments where I can know how this is resonating. It makes me so happy. It makes actually the energy so much, like, it's awesome when you leave some comments so you can support each other. You can see the Scorpius community that's going through this, or the Cross Watchers, and it helps so much. All of you, you have no idea. That's how we bond on this world, right, guys? 3D world, we have to try to still bond on our energy. So please do so, okay? I love you. I'll see you next time, guys. Bye.